After Santa's once a year all-nighter, he likes to throw a party for all his elves. That's why he stops at the entertainers. Napkins, plates, favors, balloons, everything you need is at the entertainers.
On the basis of on October 22nd, 1962, Khrushchev pounded and America stood tall. It was 4:13 p.m. Boulevard watch time. On May 3rd, 1969, Laurie Hanks appeared in person at her first rock concert at 2:40 p.m. Boulevard watch time. And today, Scott Hudson Sr. met Scott Hudson Jr. at 8:26 a.m. Bulova watch time. Bulova measures every minute of our lives, large and small. Bulova, it's America's time.
Experience the world of Superior Court.
My baby is legitimate.
A world where emotions are unleashed.
That's a lot of baloney. I never said any such thing.
A world where winning is worth whatever it takes.
I want you to look directly into your sister's eyes and tell this court that she is lying.
Cases that demand your attention. Two judges that command your respect. Superior Court. Your lives are changed forever.
Weekdays at 4:30 on TV 10. Hollywood Squares, weeknights at 7:30.
Mr. President, Colonel North, Mr. Meese, we're pleased that you could drop by the Defense Department today to discuss our latest... Mr. President?
What? Oh, I'm sorry, fellas. You know, I think I bought the wrong Christmas album. This one's got songs by Springsteen, U2, Bon Jovi, and Brian Adams.
And you wanted?
Well, Def Leppard, Whitesnake, the Blue Monkeys, Echo, and the Bunnymen.
They make great Christmas gifts.
Yes, and you're going to wrap them for me.
Yeah, right. Well, gentlemen, if we could get back to our latest weapon, and here it is, Mr. President, I think you'll be mightily impressed
with it. That's it? That's our latest nuclear weapon?
Yes, sir.
Yes, hardly the size of a tow missile, sir.
It looks so small and harmless.
Maybe there should be a warning on the side of it, sir.
Yeah, close cover before striking.
gentlemen, this is no joke. This is a 500-megaton bomb. It's the most powerful weapon in our arsenal.
Well, I don't like it. I mean, something that small could easily get into the wrong hands, and then we'd be up a...
Sir.
And besides, this is the holiday season. I don't want to think about tow missiles. I want to think about mistletoes. Hey, that was clever.
Yes, it was, sir. You're packing up. Where are you going?
I have gifts to give all my friends, and they're all down at D.C. Follies.
Tonight, nearly live from Washington, D.C., Sid and Marty Krofft present D.C. Follies. Starring Clint Willard, owner of the hottest club in Washington, D.C. And very special guest star, Santa. And the magic of the Krofft puppet.
Coming back to my place for a little Christmas cheer, you know, whatever.
There you go, kids. Merry Christmas.
Maybe I can destroy everything.
And Merry Christmas to you. Ho, ho, ho. I'm Fred, and this is my place, D.C. Follies, right down the street from the White House and the National Christmas Tree. You're here at just the right time. The Senate confirmation hearings are going on right now. Hi, Mrs. Reagan. You look very Christmassy.
Oh, well, thank you, friend.
At last count, the Senate is divided evenly on this confirmation.
Here comes committee member Edward Kennedy. Senator Kennedy. Yes, Mr. Donaldson. What are the nominee's chances for confirmation in the full Senate? Well, He appears on the surface to be fully qualified, but there are those nasty rumors of his past lifestyle and the questionable business practices. Here's the nominee now. Sir, isn't it a fact that you did some pretty high flying in your college days?
Whoa, ho, 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 ho. I still do, Sam. In fact, that's how I deliver the toys to all my girls and boys.
All the boys and girls? Then it's true. You do have an illegal monopoly on the delivery of Christmas gifts.
Well...
And Mrs. Claus. Sir, we cannot even find out her name. Are you married legally?
In fact, you're not married at all. Come clean, Mr. Claus.
Those aren't elves. They're your illegitimate children.
It's sure been a tough year for funny-looking guys with beards.
Santa has been confirmed. The Senate was deadlocked due to Senator Jesse Helms. He confused Santa Claus with Santanista. It's all cleared up, and Santa is here. For Christmas.
Hey, yes. Boy, am I glad that's resolved.
I'll meet you, Fred.
Jerry, Richard, since we are the three ex-wise men, I think we should pass on some words of wisdom for the holidays.
Good idea. I'll start. Don't spend all your goodwill during the holidays. Save some for the rest of the year.
Give a present to someone you don't like. It might start a new friendship.
Don't get your cranberry sauce too close to the mashed potatoes. It makes them all red and gooky.
Yeah, I can't believe we brought this guy on this journey. Can you believe this?
Now, Georgie, what do you want for Christmas?
Well, Santa, some crappy ties, a wrist developer, and a major scandal that had forced the president to resign right before New Hampshire.
I'll get it, Alex.
Mel's Market. Here's your order.
What order?
Side of beef.
I didn't order.
Here's your delivery, sir.
What delivery?
Your Stroh's 30 packs.
Stroh's. Alex?
Nah. Stroh's and Stroh Light. Fire brewed for smooth, consistent taste. And with 30 packs, you get more beer.
Pardon. Guess that shop. Here's your poodle.
Oh, Alex.
Ooh, my skin is dry.
Itchy.
Sensitive.
Help!
Try new Vaseline Intensive Care Formula for sensitive skin. It relieves the itch, soothes the sensitivity.
AIM innovates. A special plaque-fighting toothbrush. Straight bristles and uniquely slanted bristles feel exhilarating while they help remove plaque. AIM's Plaque Fighter. Fighting plaque never felt so good.
Some people perspire.
We sweat. So for us, Arid Double X Solid.
With the great musk scent.
And now, Arid Double X Protection comes in a new extra, extra wide solid, too.
Helps keep us extra,
extra dry.
Bob Hinden doesn't know it, but something else is about to interrupt his trip. Pain. As Bob's gotten older, he gets more aches and pains. That's why his next move is to Medifrin. Medifrin has the same medicine as Motrin, and nothing's proven faster for relief of body pain or any kind of pain. It's also gentler to your stomach than aspirin. Medifrin works fast when you haven't got time for the pain.
Hi, this is Tony from Peter Piper Pizza, and just wait till you hear this. For a limited time, get a large cheese pizza for only $2.95. That's right, $2.95. Add sausage, mushrooms, pepperoni, any of your favorite toppings, and it's not much more. Buy one or two or as many as you like. It's your choice. You pick them, we'll pack them to go, or eat them here. We've got plenty of seating. A large cheese pizza, $2.95. So come on over to Peter Piper Pizza.
Yo.
And what would you like for Christmas, Sly?
Come here, don't tell you. I want a short chick that, like, I can beat in arm wrestling, you know?
Freddy.
Oh, hello, Mr. Reagan.
Oh, here's something for you, Fred.
Why, thank you. I'll put it right here with the other gifts.
Oh, no. Open it now.
No,
you?
I'll open it with all the rest.
No, sir, please.
Oh,
please.
All right. Let's see. What did you get here? It looks like it's a stereo cassette.
cassette. Thanks, that's wonderful. Let me get this on right now.
Yes, sir, what on the left, right there?
I don't hear anything.
You have activated operation.
Oh, just one of those little munchkin computerized voices saying, you have activated Operation Doomsday.
Oh, that's you too. You know, they're big anti-nukems. What's that song, Frosty the Glow Man?
No, just some voice here. He's counting down from 12 minutes and 40 seconds.
Mr. President, I just got a call from the Pentagon, sir. You walked out with the wrong cassette.
What did I take, Depeche Mode?
No, sir, Destruct Mode. You took the bomb, Mr. President.
But... I had no knowledge.
Call the bomb squad!
Negative, soldier. Once a nuclear weapon has been activated, sir, the private sector must not be alerted. It could set off a mass panic.
Well, then that means...
We gotta disarm it ourselves.
Yeah, but who...
Well, sir,
who?
Jimmy Carter was a naval intelligence officer. Perhaps he's had some hands-on.
Good idea, Ed. Now you and Ollie guard the door. Jimmy Carter, get your hiney over here. Look, now, do you know anything about deactivating a bomb?
Well, a little.
Great, we'll go to it.
What?
It's an A-bomb, sir, the smallest of its type. Now, one missile... Mr. Carter! Mr. Carter! Well, we better revive him.
Not now. Wait till after the bomb goes off. This is an emergency. Listen up, everyone. Is there anyone here who can dismantle an A-bomb?
Gerald Ford!
I have experience in this area.
Oops.
Steady, sir.
Oh, dear. But there's no alternative.
All right. Let's take a look at this baby.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you said something about an ape.
Him.
These are sad and perilous times. Years ago, Spencer Tracy and I would kiss under the mistletoe and go out and sing Christmas carols. Oh, if he were alive today, we'd kiss under the mistletoe and go out and get a blood test.
Dick,
what? Good grief. You should have thought about that before we left the Oasis, Jerry.
Fred, how can you possibly decorate the tree when we're about to be blown up?
Well, Woody...
Carl, remember, I'm Carl Malden. Although I'm not the Carl Malden.
I know, just like you're not the Woody Allen. Even
right.
Though there's a bomb in here, the spirit of Christmas is more important.
Oh, great. Religious platitudes.
Yeah.
That's all I need.
I'll get it.
Oh, great. Who's that going to be? The angel of death?
Just relax, Woody. Just relax. Ah, Colonel,
See, I was right.
Never mind.
Fred, we got the supplies Ford needs to dismantle the bomb.
Good, bring them in.
All right, here we go. Some wire cutters, jumper cables, a jar of leeches. Yes, an enema bottle. Okay, the jaws of life, a wet swimsuit, a photo of Sky King and Penny, one sand wedge, one bottle of vodka.
A gift from the people of Russia.
Thank you.
One Teamster.
Which way is the donuts?
Two plastic explosives and an actual SLA beret once worn by Patty Hearst.
All ears.
Colonel, do you think we could have a sprig of mistletoe to keep things light?
Yes, sir. I shall run that by him. Yes, sir.
Appreciate it.
This is Geraldo Rivera. I'm about to uncover the fraud of the Santa Claus myth once and for all and unmask this corpulent fraud. Okay, off with the beard.
Whoa!
Okay, so it's a real beard. Anybody can do that. Out with this pillow. It's not a pillow. Then, Santa, it really is you. You're real. Okay, I want a hula hoop, and I want Davy Crockett hat, and Mr. Bluster puppet, and guns just like Roy's, and a pony. I want a pony. You know, my mommy told me I couldn't have a pony.
Boy, he's a pony.
Yonder I seeth a star.
A bright and shiny star.
And you wonder why the country almost went down the dumper with these two clowns.